Hey everybody, welcome back to Raw Food Muscle, and today I'm making cauliflower popcorn. Now this is that popcorn I told you guys a couple weeks ago that Philip McCluskey had made, and actually he did it on the Gianni's show. And man, when I first found out about this and I tried it out, I was like, oh, I was blown away. When you taste this, it is well worth the effort that you put into it. So, not too hard to make. It's just three ingredients is all you need. It's some olive oil, some Himalayan sea salt, or any kind of natural salt. Actually, this is Himalayan salt, not sea salt. And then some nutritional yeast. Now, I got about three cut up already cauliflowers in here, but I wanted to show you exactly what I do to get this thing cut up. So what you want to do first, I actually have this cut in half. So what you want to do is first, you can either cut it in half or you can just slam it down like that and kind of get that butt out of there. And what will happen is it'll come apart a lot easier. So what I'm going to do here real quick is just show you with a knife. I'm just going to kind of cut around so that the pieces that you get are not too small, because you don't want them too small, because when you put them in the dehydrator, it'll shrink up and then it won't have a good texture to it. It might come out too dry, so you want to be careful with that. So you want them about this size right here. So that's pretty good size right there. And let me go ahead and just cut up the rest of these. And this is something that I definitely recommend if you're into having something snacky, but you know, it's not going to taste like a popcorn, so don't get it twisted. So I know when I first tried it and I was like, you know, trying to, you know, compare it to popcorn, you know, it's not a popcorn. I'm a big popcorn lover, you know, I don't eat the stuff anymore because it just can't go through my stomach anymore. But this, you know, it's definitely good, so definitely worth trying out. So, all right, so I'm going to go ahead and scoop all this stuff in here. And what I'm going to do next is I'm going to use a separate bowl. And I'm going to do this in sections, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put a little in here now so I can layer it, okay? Because I want to make sure I get enough nutritional yeast in here and mix it all up with my hands. I used to do it in a bag, you know, a big plastic bag, and you know, you used to put all the stuff in there and mix it up. Now the problem that I had with it was that a lot of the nutritional yeast was kind of sticking on the bag, so it was just easier for me to just do it with my hands, and that way I can, you know, control how much the nutritional yeast is being spread throughout the whole entire mix. So alright, so the first thing I'm going to do is put some olive oil in here, just like that. And I'm going to put some Himalayan salt in here. And then I'm going to sprinkle some nutritional yeast. Alright, and I'm going to go ahead and mix it up a little bit, just like that. And I'm going to add more. And I'm going to add a little bit more olive oil. Alright, and just going to mix it up again. Okay, I think I'm going to put a little bit more. Because you want to make sure that there's a nice, good, thick coating on the cauliflower. Just a little bit more olive oil. You don't want nothing left bare, because you know it's you're not going to have that flavor on it. If you want to get it that nice flavor, you're going to have to make sure you get it all coated up nicely. See, like the little pieces like that, so they don't have it on there. So I'm just going to go ahead and just drizzle a little bit more. And I think that's probably good to go. Alright, mix it up one more time. Now this is pretty easy to mix up. Only thing is,
You know, when you go get the cauliflower, organic cauliflower, around here, it's like $4 a head. I mean, it's crazy how much they charge, and that's why I'm going to grow my own in my own garden, so I ain't playing around. I'm taking it serious this time. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and put it on the tray, just like this. And you don't want to have too much on here, because you want to make sure that they're spread out enough so that they get, you know, a little bit of air in between all the cauliflower. Alright, so I think that's pretty good. And man, we actually, my wife and I, we actually went to the movie theaters. A miracle, because we ain't been in the movie theater in like 7 years, man. 7 years! That's a long time! You know what I'm saying? My mother-in-law, she's like, you know, for Valentine's Day, she agreed to take care of the kids, you know, all four of the kids. And, you know, so we were like, oh my God, this is such a crazy treat. We got to go out and do something. So we decided to go see Avatar, man. Avatar is the bomb. Oh, man, if y'all haven't seen that movie, oh, y'all need to check that movie out, man. That movie was just, it was on point. So, and yes, I snuck in some of my treats, man, some of my raw treats. I ain't playing around with that stuff. So anyway, let me go ahead and put this in the dehydrator. And I'm going to follow with y'all in a little bit. All right, so I'll see you in a little bit. All right, guys, we're back. And I forgot to mention to you how long I put them in there for, because I pretty much had them in there overnight. But, you know, it was kind of, early, around 7 o'clock at nighttime. So these have been in here or in the dehydrator for about 12 hours or so. So, and when you put them in there, you might want to, you know, make note that you might need to turn the sheet around. Because a lot of times, some of the back ones will get, dehydrated a lot quicker. So, you know, you can flip it around like that kind of thing. It's up to you, really. Also, you can tell some of the smaller pieces, like these, are going to be more crispy. And here you got some of the bigger pieces. Now, these are still good. Don't get me wrong. They're still good. But, you know, they're not going to have that crispier texture like the real small ones. So something to make note of when you're making these. And you know, I like them either way. They're really good either way. Wow, these are probably, I don't know, man, they're up there as far as one of my favorite snacks to have. And I tell you, when I make these, I probably make about 3 to 4 heads of cauliflower, and it goes fast. So I mean, at least for me, because I turn them up quick. But yeah, it's an excellent snack. You know, you want to sneak it into the movie theaters, you know, be undercover like me. That's cool. You just got to watch out for the flashlight cop coming at you. Come up. I see you. All right. So, see, look at that. You can also see, this one might not have quite as much of the seasoning. Oh yeah, before I forget, the seasoning isn't truly raw. A lot of raw fooders use it, so I use it. And this is good, so you know, whatever, we're gonna use it anyway. But try this recipe out. I think it's an excellent snack to have and to add to your little craving. So I'll see y'all next time on Raw Food Muscle.